On October 16th, 1850, Fontana married Emilia Rouanet Coma. This was followed by a period of life in Prussian service as a journalist and patriotic writer. Writing was his passion, in whatever form. Fontana was a lyricist, wrote ballads, penned prose texts, journalistic texts, and was a theater critic. He worked as a correspondent, editor, he wrote reviews, and he was a publicist in general. Fontana traveled to places of scenic and cultural interest. He lived in England from 1855 to 59, and later traveled to current theaters of war. This provided him with material for two further literary genres, travel literature, such as his famous Wanderung durch die Mark Brandenburg, and war reporting. In 1862, Fontana began the first chapters of his novel Before the Storm, which he didn't publish until 15 years later, in line with his maxim, courage is good, endurance is better. Fontana thus realized his dream. He resigned from all his posts in 1876, and this marked the second turning point in Fontana's life after giving up his profession as a pharmacist. Fontana began his main literary work in the sixth decade of his life. As a chronicler of the Wilhelminian era between 1870 and 1895, Fontana captured the reality of life in his time. The social spectrum in his realistic social novels encompassed the nobility, military and clergy, bourgeoisie and workers in all its varieties. In 1892, Fontana fell ill with brain ischemia and suffered from severe depression for months. On the advice of his doctor, Fontana wrote down his childhood memories to distract himself from the illness. He recovered so well that he completed Effie Briest, the pinnacle of poetic realism in Germany. This was followed by Die Poggenpools and Der Stechlin, Fontana's last novel. Fontana died unexpectedly 1 month before publication. The Neue Freie Presse reported, Fontana had been having soup with his children yesterday evening, went to his bedroom in a state of complete well-being, and was found dead there soon afterwards. Theodore Fontana recognized the weaknesses of his time and portrayed them realistically in his many dialogues. Well, so much for Theodore Fontana, and until the next episode of 5-Minute Bios.